Hi, I'm Christine Bullock and this is Remi Rain. Welcome back to my YouTube. Remi just hit a major milestone, eating her first foods. I did a lot of research into this and I figured out how to meld the French and American ways, and I'm going to show you how to do just that. One of the first questions you're gonna ask when you're ready to feed your baby their first foods is, how old should they be? I feel like I heard from a lot of mommies, four through six months, but when you look at a lot of the organizations out there, many of them say wait till around 6 months, and some of these organizations, I have my cheat sheet just so you know how serious this is. It's the World Health Org, UNICEF, American Academy of Pediatricians, American Academy of Family Physicians, Australian National in Health and Medical Research, and even Health Canada. So it's all around the world. They're recommending a little later. Now that being said, I actually started Remi a little later than 5 and a half, but I could tell she really needed food at that point. So just listen to, you know, the signs that your baby is giving you. A reason that they're recommending waiting till about 6 months is that your baby has what's called a bit of an open gut still. And so that's good. It basically allows macromolecules like proteins to absorb into the baby's bloodstream. That's great when you're breastfeeding, but when you start to feed the baby food, other things can start to absorb into the bloodstream. So you just want to push that and stretch it for as long as you can on breast milk or formula, and then add the food. A sign that the baby may not be as ready is that it gets really gassy. So check with your physician, see if you can back off the food a little bit or change up the foods. One of the first things that you want to do when you're ready to start feeding your baby foods, even before the puree, is create a broth. And this actually comes from the French method. Get some really basic vegetables, yellow squash, zucchini, that kind of stuff. Create a broth with it, and then add a little bit at first, and you can kind of keep adding a little bit more into a bottle for them to drink or into the formula. We started this even a little bit earlier because Remi started to have a reaction to dairy, and I had to put her on soy formula, which I wasn't thrilled about, so I wanted to make sure she was getting a lot of nutrients, and she absolutely loved the taste of the broth. As you start introducing the foods, think about taste development. This is the huge thing that differs from American cultures to French cultures. If you ask any moms, or like my moms, grandmas, all that kind of stuff, the first things that they fed children around our age typically were rice cereal and oat cereal. And it just didn't make sense to me. I was like, there's all these fresh fruits and vegetables. Why am I gonna feed them processed foods? So I did a little research into the French method, and they are so about taste development of a child. They actually feed a new food every 3 to 5 days. In the first month, they can give a child from 6 but up to 12 new vegetables and fruits to try, as opposed to Americans, which are a bit less, 3 to 6 days they try. Germans, they said it was like only like 3 or 4 new foods in the first month. So you want to give them a variety, first of all. Also, you know, the first time we gave Remi any kind of new food, you know, there's a hesitancy, maybe a little bit of crying, she would push it away. We'd come back the second day and she was more likely to enjoy it. What the French say too is that it takes about 15 days for a child to learn a taste and really start to enjoy a taste. So don't worry if that in 3 days they don't like it, move on to the next vegetable, and in a couple of days, come back to that. Don't worry that they don't like it right away. Just keep coming back to that and they're gonna learn the taste. This is really important because the French Society of Pediatricians have done some research and they found around the ages of 3 to 4 years old, 5 years old, that children get neophobia. It's fear of eating new foods. And we see this, I know my nieces and my nephews, and you've seen this in your children, I'm sure. So that's why it's so important to feed your children 3 to 4 meals a day with a variety of fruits and vegetables and taste. And that will increase their taste development. So what foods to start out with? It's like such an important question. You get so excited to give them first foods. One of the first things I was thinking is peas. It's a really basic vegetable, correct? I started doing my research and I found that the French wait until the baby is at least 7 months old, 7 months old to give them peas, and they even watch. It's actually hard. There's proteins in it that are hard for the baby to digest. You remember from the beginning of the conversation, we talked about those macromolecules. So maybe hold off on the peas. I started with light colored vegetables and I kind of went through the color chart. So we started actually with a yellow squash for her first food. And you won't believe it, but her second food, it was like a test for myself. We gave her leek and the white part of leek, and she absolutely loved it. So we gave her leek next. And then we started to move into the orange vegetables, like sweet potato and other, like orange squash, carrots, which I actually read through the French method, you have to be careful because they're so fibrous, but she was absolutely fine on the orange carrots. And then we started to move into apple and pear. I wanted to do as many vegetables taste first before I gave her the sweets of the fruits. And actually, she still loves the taste of vegetables, and she was a little averted to the sweetness of fruit at first. Then we started adding spinach, and I would add that to the apple once we knew she wasn't allergic to it. So I have a list for you created by the French Society of Pediatricians, the FSP, of foods that are okay to eat at 6 months old. It's my cheat sheet. So we have an orange squash, a pumpkin, a sweet potato, carrots, but watch, apple, pear, spinach, beets, bananas, and then stove fruits like mangoes. So two notes. I have not done beets yet because I don't want purple exploding out of her diaper as of yet. Who knows if we wait till potty training for that one. I also added in Swiss chard with the spinach and she was fine. Bananas. It's another food that mommy start off with and it's very fibrous. Just watch if the baby gets constipated with it and back off. It's also a higher allergy food. Remi broke out with a red rash all over her face from the bananas. So just beware. So around 7 months, you're increasing that taste development. You can add a couple more fruits and veggies. One of the ones that Remi loved was avocado, and she now eats at least a half an avocado a day, which I love because she's getting her vitamins and nutrients, and now she's getting her healthy fats. So her hair started to grow, and you could tell she just started it. Well, she already has baby smooth skin, but I wanted those for her brain and for her development. And then again, from the FSP, asparagus. And their peels start to smell weird, so don't worry about that, it's asparagus. You can add an onion in, so like let's say you're making some asparagus and spinach or a broth, you can add an onion into it. I probably wouldn't give it to them straight. Fennel. Remi would get a little bit gassy, I think, because she was a formula baby instead of breastfed, and so we'd have to watch the foods. So I would add fennel into a lot of her food. She loved the taste of it, and it also helps to prevent bloating and gas. And this is where they start to add the peas, and I already gave you the warning about the peas, so just beware. At this time, I started to add in the purple color as well, like purple carrots and purple potato. This is my personal choice, and we had no problem, but make sure to check with your doctor. Another thing that we added around 7 months was a breakfast cereal, like oats or rice. Let me actually grab it. So after doing a bit of research into this as well, I found that the rice contains 6 times higher arsenic than oats out there. So just to play it safe, I still haven't given Remi any rice cereal or rice cakes or anything like that. And it's really easy to make oats. I mean, you could have just stone cut oats, your regular oatmeal, and you can put it in a grinder and make it yourself. But I found this one at Whole Foods. It's Happy Baby Organic Probiotic Baby Cereal. So it's getting her a couple, you know, some good probiotics as well. And you can see that it's really fine grain. We add her formula into it. And around this time too, we added some dried prunes to it as well to help, you know, Remi go to the bathroom. So she gets that almost every morning now. There are a few high allergy, high warning foods. Take a look at this list and don't feed it to the baby until they're around one and check with your doctor first. And I wouldn't want you to leave without learning how to make these easy purees at home. So let's take a second and just look at how easy this can be. First, you can take any kind of vegetable and you're gonna chop it up. You can steam it and then put it in a blender. I actually don't even have time for that. I'd probably burn the vegetables. So we have the baby brezza. This has been one of the best tools that we've had for Remi so far, completely. Basically, you're just gonna chop up the vegetables or fruit. We have pear in here right now. And you throw them in there. There's a bit of water in the top that I filled. Close it up. And I literally press a button over here from 5 to 35 minutes, depending on like how fibrous. This would be like a 10 minute steam. This would, sweet potato would be like a 25 minute steam. And at the end of it steaming it, it purees it all by itself and it's ready to go. So it's great. I can put it in, I can walk away, I can work, I can play with the baby, I can work out, and the food is ready for her. We actually have traveled with this so I can make the food when we're traveling. And then after you're done, you just want a couple containers, know the sizing, so these are each 2 ounce containers so we know how much we're feeding her. And you know, you'll just need some water nearby just in case, just like any other person, they need water, but just in case, you know, at first you may choke a little bit or cough a bit, you wanna have water nearby. And some tiny spoons, she has a really tiny mouth, so these OXO spoons are also some of our favorites. And it's as easy as that. Pick your first foods, go through the rainbow of colors, make sure to just transition every 3 to 5 days that first month. Don't worry about the baby not liking it, and keep it up. Keep feeding them those meals, 3 to 4 meals a day, a complete variety. I make sure she's getting from purple to orange to green throughout each and every day. And feed that baby those healthy foods that she wants.